In this video, you're going to learn everything you need about the metrics to scale and optimize your Google Shopping campaigns. Metrics are what we use to track and measure the performance of our campaigns. Now, we need to learn what these metrics are and how to use them so that we know that when we optimize our campaigns, we're focusing on the data and the performance that really matters. Here are the main metrics we're going to learn about in this video. I'll also add a link below this video to our metric handbook. Our metric handbook is a deeper guide to all the metrics you need for Google Shopping and an explanation of each one. First, let's talk about impressions. An impression occurs when your ad is served on a page, like the Google search results. Basically, someone seeing your ad is an impression. If it's served to 10 different people, it's counted as 10 impressions. If it's served 10 times to the same person, that's still 10 impressions. Unfortunately, an impression occurs when the ad is shown on the page, even if the visitor didn't even see it because it's below the fold. This is good to know in case you're getting a lot of impressions, but not many clicks. You may just have a poor ad position on the page, such as all the way down the bottom where no one is really seeing it. Number two, clicks. A click is counted when someone actually clicks your ad. Keep in mind that they just need to click the ad, not actually fully load the page. They can click your ad and immediately hit the back button or shut the window down. However, Google promises that they take care of any suspicious traffic like this, where it could be a competitor trying to cost you money. If you're worried about invalid clicks like these, I'll leave a link to some resources below where you can go and read more about this topic. Next, we have the click-through rate. Your click-through rate is a measure of how many of your impressions actually became clicks. For example, if you had 50 impressions and 5 clicks, your click-through rate is 10%. Sometimes you'll see a click-through rate of above 100%, like 2 clicks and 1 impression. So what is happening here? Well, it means that a shopper clicked on your ad twice to get to your store, even though they only saw your ad once. This is possible because a served ad can get cached by a browser and doesn't get served again. It can happen, but don't worry about it too much. Google hasn't messed up the math on you, and yes, they'll still charge you for both clicks. Next, we have cost, or ad spend. This is the running total of what Google will be charging you for those clicks. Note that the words spend, ad spend, and cost are used interchangeably. Also, your cost can change if Google determines that there were invalid clicks. Next, we have conversions. Conversions are an action or event that gets recorded. In this course, we're going to focus on one type of conversion, which is the completed action of a purchase on your website. We'll go into far more detail about this later, but just know that orders, purchases, and conversions are used interchangeably throughout this course. Now, conversions are recorded from the date of the click. This means that if a shopper clicks your ad on Tuesday, but only converts on a Wednesday for whatever reason, the conversion is going to show up on Tuesday's data. You do have the option for viewing your conversions when they actually occurred by setting up the conversions by conversion time value column if you prefer. Next, we have the conversion rate. The conversion rate is simply the proportion of clicks that turned into conversions. For example, if 100 shoppers clicked on your ad and 2 turned into conversions, your conversion rate is 2%. You'll spend a lot of time obsessing over this metric because improving it has a huge impact on the performance and profitability of your campaigns. It's a metric that provides a good indication of the quality of your traffic and how well your store converts this traffic into customers. Next, we have conversion value. This is basically your total sales. It's the total revenue generated from the orders. Whenever I talk about sales or revenue, I'm talking about conversion value. Lastly, we have ROAS, return on ad spend. It's also known and seen in your Google Ads account as conversion value divided by cost. ROAS, or conversion value over cost, is the total sales divided by the total ad spend, or total cost. This metric tells you some very important information. For every $1 you put into your ads, how much in sales do you get back? This tells you about the profitability of your ads. Google calls it conversion value over cost to make it easier. I usually call it ROAS, which means return on ad spend. ROAS and conversion value are the two most important metrics in your Google Ads account because it tells you how much actual profit you're generating. Okay guys, they are the main metrics we'll need to optimize and scale our Google Shopping campaigns. This video you're watching right here is actually one of the videos in our free Google Shopping course that's on our website. It's 100% free with no sign up required. Go check it out. I'll leave a link to the full course down below. If this video was helpful, please give it a like and let me know in the comments section below. Let's get into the next video.